गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। गुड
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
मॉर्निंग मैम।
मैम
की मैसेज ओके, वेयर वी लेफ्ट इन द लास्ट क्लास, व्हाट वाज द लास्ट टॉपिक? समवन काइंडली टेल मी व्हाट वाज द लास्ट टॉपिक, वेयर वी लेफ्ट इन द लास्ट क्लास?
Charge of proton and electron.
Charge of proton and electron. Okay. Coulomb's law start kora nasilu na last class ot.
Ma'am.
Coulomb's law start korisu ni ki idea son.
Na kora.
ओके ठीक है सर। ओके, सो इन द अर्लियर क्लास वी हैव लर्न्ड अबाउट इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज, टाइप्स ऑफ चार्ज, प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ चार्ज एंड चार्ज ऑफ प्रोटॉन एंड इलेक्ट्रॉन। सो व्हाट वाज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज? What was the definition of electric charge? Tell me. Tumalukor copy keikhono uswar ase sai kine koi dile etu hoy. Charge or definition o monot nai niki karo. चार्ज इज द इंट्रिंसिक प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मैटर ड्यू टू व्हिच ए मैटर प्रोड्यूसेस इलेक्ट्रिक एंड मैग्नेटिक इफेक्ट्स। ओके, हाउ मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ चार्ज आर देयर इन नेचर? इजीएस्ट क्वेश्चन, हाउ मेनी चार्जेस आर देयर इन नेचर? No one knows that or what? Yes.
Conservative charge.
Types of charge is conservative charge. Huh?
No, ma'am, positive and negative.
Yes. Easiest question in the world. How many charges are there in nature? No one knows that. You তোমালোকে ক্লাসটো খতম কৰাৰ পিছত এবাৰ ৰিভিজন দিবা আগৰ ক্লাসটো কি পঢ়ালো এবাৰ চেক কৰি চাবা So there are two types of charges, positive charge and negative charge. Positive charges are the protons and negative charges are the electrons. Okay. Okay, so tell me some properties of charge. Tell me some properties of charge.
Charge is a scalar quantity.
Yes. And
SI unit of charge.
The SI unit of charge is coulomb. This is not a property. This is just a this is just the unit of charge. Your first answer is correct. Opposite charges. Attract each other. Yes. Next.
Opposite charges are attraction and same charge are repulsion.
Yes. And charge can be transferred or not. Next, charge can be counted only in discrete values, and charge is taken as integral multiple. Charge of a system is taken as the integral multiple of charge of electron. And what was the charge of proton and electron? What was the charge of proton and electron?
Electron have negative charge.
Ma'am, 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19.
Yes, 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb with a negative sign. Right? For electron, it is minus 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. And for proton, plus 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Okay. So for today we are going to learn about Coulomb's law. See, we know that positive charges attract each other and negative charge positive and negative charges attract each other, and positive charge will repel positive charge, negative charge will repel negative charge. Opposite charges attract each other, right? So when they attract or repel, when charges attract or repel each other, they use some force for that attraction and repulsion process, right? That force is Coulomb's law. So when we bring two charges near to each other, they may get attracted towards each other, or they may get repelled. So that attraction and repulsion, the two forces attract each other or repel each other with some forces. That force is called Coulomb's law. Okay, Coulomb explained about this force, and that's why this is called Coulomb's law. So according to this law, the magnitude of the electric force between two static point charges in vacuum is directly proportional to the product of the magnitude of the two charges and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them and acts along the line joining the two charges. The magnitude of Coulomb's law is given by the expression F equal to K Q1 Q2 by R square. So suppose two charges Q1 and Q2, we bring them together and they will attract each other and repel each other with a force. that force is proportional to the product of these two charges, F proportional to Q1, Q2. F is directly proportional to the product of the two charges. That means when the charges have higher magnitude, then the force will be greater. If they have lower magnitude, force will be lesser. Or force directly proportional to the magnitude of the charges, product of their magnitudes. So next is, so this force is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. As these two forces get closer, the force of attraction and repulsion gets higher. The force will be greater as the two forces comes closer, or the distance is getting lesser. And when the distance is getting more, or distance is the two charges are going away from each other, then the force will be less. That means the force is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. Okay, so that means force is inversely proportional to the square of the distance. As distance getting lesser, force getting higher. As distance getting higher, force getting lesser. That means with the increase of distance, force decreases. Okay, so we know that F proportional to 1 by R square. That means F is proportional to Q1, Q2. That means F is proportional to Q1, Q2 by R square. Now, if we want to get a particular value, we have to remove that proportionality sign, right? So, to remove a proportionality sign, we always have to put a constant. So, F equal to K Q1, Q2 by R square. K is the proportionality constant. So, where F is the electrostatic force, this force between this attraction and repulsion force is called electrostatic force. And this force always acts on the straight line joining the two charges. Okay. This force is electrostatic force. So, F is the electrostatic force between two charges Q1 and Q2 separated by distance R. K is the proportionality constant. The value of K is 9 into 10 to the power 9 newton meter square divided by coulomb square. Okay, so Coulomb's law is also called inverse square law because the force is directly proportional to the force is inversely proportional to the square of the distance. Therefore, Coulomb's law is also called inverse square law. Okay, next is electric field. So, we know that the charges with opposite sign attract each other and charges with same electrical sign repel each other. So, when they attract and repel each other, only a particular area that attraction and repulsion force can work. When the two charges are too apart from each other, the distance is very large between them, then there will be no force of attraction or repulsion. So, up to a particular area only, that force can effect. So that area around a charged particle is called the electric field. A positive charge and negative charge is said to be create its field around itself. This space around a charge in which another charged particle experiences a force is said to have electrical field in it. The electrical field is a vector quantity, and the direction of field lines depends on the sign of the source charge. Electric field vectors point away from positively charged source and toward negatively charged source. So, the area around a charged particle up to which it can attract and repel another charged particle is called the electric field of the charged particle. So, to know the charged particle, we will take a source charge. That source charge can be a positive charge and it can also be a negative charge. And when we bring a test charge, that test charge is a unit positive charge. Test charge is always a unit positive charge. When we bring the unit positive charge near the positive source charge, it will get repelled. So the direction of the force will be towards the outwards. The direction of force will be outwards, right? And when we bring the unit positive charge closer to the negative source charge, then it will get attracted. So it will be the towards the source charge, right? So that's how we will calculate the direction of the electric field depending upon the sign of the source charge. If the source charge is positive, then the electric field lines will be outwards, and if the electric field will be outwards, if the source charge is negative, electric field will be inwards. So that's how we will calculate the direction of electric field. Basically, electric field is the area around a charged particle up to which it can attract or repel another charged particle. So any questions?
Man.
Yes.
Repeat.
Which part?
Electric field.
Electric field. Okay. So we know that positive and negative charges can attract each other, and negative, positive, repel each other, right? So when the distance between the two charges are too long, then they cannot attract and repel each other. Only up to a particular distance, two charges can attract and repel each other. That area around a charged particle up to which it can attract and repel another charged particle is called its electric field. Area around itself up to which it can attract or repel another charged particle is the electric field of that charged particle. To set electric field or the direction of the electric field, since electric field is a vector quantity, it has a direction, right? So to set that direction, we will take a source charge and we will take another test charge. Okay, so for the source charge, it can be positive and also negative. The test charge is always a unit positive charge. When we bring the unit positive charge around the positive test positive source charge, it will get repelled, right? Because both are positive, it will get repelled. And when we bring the unit test charge closer to the negative source charge, it will get attracted. That means the direction of electric field in this case will be inwards. And in the first case, where the source charge is positive, then the positive test charge will get repelled, right? That's why the direction will be outwards. For a positive charge, the electric field, the direction of electric field is taken inwards, and for negative charge, the direction of electric field is taken as outwards depending upon the unit positive charge, which is taken as the test charge. Now you have understood? Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Okay, any question? Okay, give me your attendance.